Today, I'm introducing the new Genesis Swarm that takes us a step closer towards self-expanding artificial intelligence. With my framework, Agency Swarm, you can now create your own agents without writing a single line of code. But here's the best part. The more agents we create, the more powerful our library becomes. Every agent that you contribute on GitHub can now be instantly imported by the Genesis Swarm, allowing others to benefit from it too. Towards the end of this video, I'll show you exactly how to contribute, but for now, let's just see this incredible demo where I create a Bitcoin investing agency with just a couple of prompts. Let's dive in. If you're new here, welcome to this channel. My name is Arsen and my goal is to automate my entire AI agency with AI. To achieve this, I've developed an open source framework called Agency Swarm, which allows you to easily orchestrate AI agents built on top of the latest OpenAI Assistance API. So let's dive in and see how this Genesis agency works. Okay, I'm going to request a Bitcoin investing agency and just see what happens. First, the CEO wants to know about my mission, goals, and which APIs I want to use. All right, my goal is to provide up-to-date analysis and focus on achieving high returns. I also want to utilize the Binance API and browse the web for the latest news. Now, the CEO agent immediately proposes the initial structure for my agency, which actually looks pretty good. Sometimes you might want to adjust it, but I'm pretty content with this, so I'm just going to tell it to proceed. After the Genesis CEO creates our agency folder, it tells the agent creator agent to create the first agent, which is the market analyzer. The agent creator first checks if there are any available agents in our framework using the get available agents tool. As I said before, all agents that you contribute on GitHub will automatically be available via this tool. However, since there are no agents available for interacting with the Binance API just yet, it proceeds with creating it manually using the create agent template tool. Then it tells the browsing agent to find the most relevant APIs for this agent to use. The browsing agent from my previous video immediately pulls up the browsing window and starts searching for the Binance API in Google. It navigates to the correct documentation page, exports it using the new export file tool, and then communicates this file ID to the agent creator agent. With this new groundbreaking tool, the browsing agent can now export whole web pages as PDFs and then instantly upload them to OpenAI for further analysis with the retrieval tool. This means that you no longer have to worry about missing out on any information or hitting the context window. Additionally, your agents can now communicate these files to one another via the send message tool, but more on this later. Okay, next the agent creator agent sends this file via the message files parameter to the OpenAPI creator agent. After that, the OpenAPI creator extracts all the necessary information from this web page and creates an OpenAPI schema using the create tools from schema tool. You can see this new OpenAPI schema in a schemas folder of the market analyzer agent. This folder is also a new addition to my framework. Essentially, all schemas that you put in this folder will automatically be processed and then converted into tools for your agents to use. Next, the Genesis CEO sends the next agent, which is the news harvester agent. The browsing agent again initiates a search using Google and locates a link to the crypto news API. However, this time, the page does not contain the actual API documentation. Nevertheless, seems like it hallucinated a bit and still exported the file. So let's see what happens next. Upon receiving this file, the OpenAPI creator notifies the agent creator that this file in fact does not contain the actual API documentation. Then the agent creator tells this to the browsing agent so it can continue searching. This is another cool advantage of using agent swarms, because a single agent would never be able to recover from a hallucination like this. The browsing agent then browses through a few more windows and finally navigates to the correct link. Then it exports the file and sends it back to the agent creator, who then sends it to the OpenAPI creator. Now the OpenAPI creator agent successfully analyzes this page with the retrieval tool and then creates a valid OpenAPI schema. To finalize the agency, a special tool is executed by the Genesis CEO, which essentially adds all the imports for all new agents and then formats the agency file. After this step, the Genesis CEO informs me that the agency creation process is complete and I can run it with the Python agency.py command. Awesome. So let's check this out. You can check out the complete agency folder with all the agents and their respective OpenAPI schemas locally. However, before we can use this agency, there is one more step involved. We need to obtain the actual API keys because our agents will be interacting with real APIs. For Binance, I simply navigate to the API management page and then create a system generated key. To add your API keys, you can now specify them in a new API headers or API params properties of your agent, depending on where your keys are required. Keep in mind that you have to specify the file name from your schemas folder as well. So the structure of these properties is a dictionary where keys are file names and values are other dictionaries containing API parameters or API headers for your API. Now let's repeat the same process for the CryptoNews API. The API key for CryptoNews is located under the Accounts tab, and I use API params property this time because according to their documentation, it needs to be in the query parameters rather than in headers. To test our new Bitinvest agent swarm, I navigate into the agency folder and run the Python agency.py command. Then I simply copy and paste the link into the browser. Now let's find out if it's a good time to buy Bitcoin. After I send the question, the CEO instructs the market analyzer to assess the latest market data. The market analyzer then utilizes the Get Average Prices API endpoint and sends back today's live Bitcoin prices. After that, the CEO requests the News Harvester agent to gather the most recent news. The News Harvester employs the Get Trending News API endpoint and then sends back a complete report. With all this information, our CEO finally compiles a thorough analysis of the current Bitcoin market. This analysis includes the latest prices and trending articles categorized by sentiments. The market is liquid with normal trading volume, and it seems like Elon Musk is back in the crypto game. So in the end, CEO concludes that if I'm willing to take risks, investing in Bitcoin might be worth considering. So yeah, not an investing advice. It's kind of incredible, honestly. The first time I ran this, I couldn't believe that it actually worked, and I still have plenty of ideas for improvement, like automating testing APIs as well. However, for complete transparency, the API schema for the CryptoNews API wasn't exactly correct. The OpenAPI creator used the incorrect server URL, most likely because the actual API endpoints were hidden on an exported page. If this happens, you can simply adjust your schemas manually or communicate this information to the CEO. Now, before I show you how to test and run this yourself, let me walk you through all of these groundbreaking updates. First and foremost, we finally have proper tests. We now have a working CI pipeline on GitHub, so you can expect a more stable experience. Second, here are the exciting news. Agents can now communicate files between each other using the message files parameter. This opens up a world of new use cases. For example, you can create a report agent that compiles a complete report based on your sources and then connect it with the report analyzer agent that extracts meaningful insights from this file. Third, Tool Factory has leveled up as well. Creating tools from OpenAPI schemas can now be done in just one line of code. Or you can simply drop your schemas, as I said before, in a schemas folder and specify this folder path when initializing your agent. Then all your schemas in this folder will automatically be converted into tools for your agent to use. And last but not least, introducing the Genesis Agency, a collection of four agents: the Genesis CEO, the agent creator, the OpenAPI creator, and a browsing agent from my previous video. The real game changer is how these agents are combined together, each one supporting the functions of another. Like for example, the browsing agent searching for docs and OpenAPI creator agent creating schemas from these docs, while the agent creator creates the instructions and CEO sets the whole agency manifesto. Now, let's dive in and see how you can test this yourself. To get started, follow these steps. Clone the agency swarm repo from GitHub or ensure that you have the latest changes by using the git pull origin main command. Create and activate a virtual environment using conda or venv using the following command. Install the requirements.py file and then also install Jupyter. Run the Jupyter notebook command inside the notebooks folder and open Jupyter in your browser. Then run all the cells from the Genesis agency notebook, making sure to add your own OpenAI key. Open the URL under the demo grader command and now you should be good to go. As you chat with the Genesis CEO, you will see all the agent files being created in the same main notebooks folder. If you create something cool, don't forget to contribute it on GitHub. To do so, please refer to the new contributing.md file, which contains all the necessary steps and folder structures. Our goal here is to organize these agents and tools by specific categories such as coding, browsing, or investing. This should make it much easier for the Genesis agency to determine which agents to use. Each agent folder and tool should follow a predefined structure outlined in the contributing.md file. Once you have made the necessary changes, create a pull request with a description and, if possible, include tests for your tools. Schemas you can simply drop in the schemas folder of your agent. Once your tools and agents are reviewed and merged, they will be instantly accessible by the Genesis Swarm so other users won't have to recreate them from scratch. Also, don't forget to add agent descriptions, because this is how the agent creator agent will determine if your agent is suitable for the task. In conclusion, just a few months ago, I would have never imagined that AGI would be open sourced. However, after collaborating with all of you on this framework, my perspective has shifted. While I still believe that the most advanced AI models will forever be closed sourced, I now have faith that the open source community will still be the one to create AGI using these models. To be honest, I believe that OpenAI itself has yet to fully grasp the full potential of the models that they have just released. And with the agency Swarm being built on top of their latest assistance API, we might as well be the ones to build it. Seriously, just take a look at this tweet where Greg Brockman recently confirmed that memory is indeed coming to ChatGPT. Which API do you think will be used for this feature? So imagine if every one of us contributes their agents to this project and we keep improving on them until each agent is expert in its own role. Soon enough, we could potentially cover nearly every single job on Earth. And with these advancements coming to this API weekly, we can only imagine where this goes in the future. And if you still don't think that's possible, please take a look at my previous video where the browsing agent literally cracks captchas better than myself. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe.